You've also got this little sheet right here. It talks about deck tennis installations. Now, I don't know if you guys are familiar with what they call deck tennis. Out on the East Coast, I guess down in Chicago, in some of the areas where you have country clubs and so forth. They have elevated tennis platforms where people can go out and snowy weather, you can still play tennis. It's smaller than a traditional tennis court, I guess.
It's almost like paddle ball.
Yeah, and there's a huge following.
It's becoming very big.
You could Google deck tennis and it will give you designs of all the different places that design deck tennis platforms and everything else. Well, anyway, getting on with this thing, what I wanted to share with you is, you know, the deck tennis sport is typically elevated, and the old deck tennis platforms used to be had like 6x6 pressure treated wood substructures and so forth. Then you'd have, pardon me, an aluminum deck with little slots cut in it. Little bitty slots, only about that wide, maybe that long, something of that nature. People would get up there, you know, people at the country club, they'd play tennis. Now, how they're made now is the deck tennis platforms are made of aluminum substructures. Everything is pretty much non-combustible. And we were getting a lot of questions over the last few years. We get people saying, hey, you know, or fire marshals would be calling in saying, you know, I'm visiting customer XYZ here, and I see he's got some of these Tradesman 400s, and I'm looking that up on your website, and they're listed as a construction company. What's it doing under the deck tennis thing here? Well, we also allow use. I mean, we're pretty specific about application of the products. I mean, you don't want to be putting these in a garage or a shop or anything else, frankly, because they're non-vented. Construction sites have pretty good air exchange, and they work great in there. Garages and shops are pretty tightly enclosed. And being non-vented, they give off CO2 and so forth. So you can become pretty sick. So Fire Marshal Bob was looking at the product and he was saying, is that okay? Yes, it was. Well, do you have something that says we can, that customer ABC can use that for his deck tennis? Well, that's what this thing does, this sheet right here. That might be what you're about, right? And the only thing is, though, yeah, we do allow their use, but there are some caveats to that. What are some of the caveats? Well, number one, you know, this thing's designed as a construction heater, and as a construction heater, we have to supply to meet the ANSI standard to which the product was approved, as tested through CSA, Canadian Standards Association in Cleveland. We have to supply a hose and a regulator. That hose and regulator might not be applicable to this product under a deck tennis type of installation because you're not working with one heater, one tank, one regulator. You're working with maybe a 500 or 1,000 gallon tank, and that's branching off and it's feeding four heaters under a deck. They might be hard piped in. So you're not going to use the regulator that came with the product. You're not going to use the hose. So what we do is say, you can do this, but some accessories that ship with the product might not be applicable to the product use. They have to be installed by someone that's licensed, someone that's certified in that area. You have to keep clearances to combustibles. And I forget what that said. Typical clearances.
6 inches.
This heater is like 15 feet, just blowing out into this room. Now, if you've got non-combustible material, maybe an aluminum support or something like that, well, those are relaxed a little bit. And those clearances are discussed in that sheet that everybody has as part of their packet. Same thing holds true on the air inlet and on the sides. It's relaxed, providing the material is made of non-combustible material, aluminum. We also state that, hey, you don't want this thing sitting in the mud because underneath the platform, you got dirt. Now you've got snowmelt dripping down. Well, that creates a mud, right? You got to have the electrical supply to this heater installed properly. You don't want to have a whole bunch of extension cords laying around that have male to female connections. What about protection of the heater? You say there should be some type of like slope roof to allow snow melt to run off. How about this thing sitting in puddle water? No, you don't want that either. So it's got to be on some type of elevated platform, like a slab or something, concrete slab, so that it's not sitting in all that crud under the deck tents. Now, if the guy does that, Mr. Fire Marshal, then we do okay. Now, this you can put under. This one you can put under. Those are mentioned in there. There are also some other style heaters that we manufacture. They're called the Guardian series of line. They're more of the agricultural design product. They're kind of boxy like that rear 170. They're used in animal confinement buildings, like pigs and chickens, big poultry confinement buildings. And we allow their use for that application for those products. Gang and I were talking about this before the session. The one heater that we didn't put on there was the Premier. Now you can also put the Premiers in that type of application too. It's just that the same rules apply to the installation of the product, right? And there's thermoblower heaters that are greenhouse heaters. People have installed those on the outside of the deck skirting and they're blowing in. So there's a lot of different products you can use. So, I mean, if you guys are familiar with this, and maybe who's here from Chicago? Anybody? You guys are, okay? Maybe you've seen or heard of deck tents before. If not, maybe there's something you want to venture into. So, Mike, anything you want to add to that?
I'll get you edited in there. So,
thanks for mentioning that. I appreciate that very much. So I would have overlooked it if you hadn't mentioned it. But anyway, just be aware of it. It's another application for the product, but you gotta watch some of the accessories and how they're installed and how the heaters do get installed. You know, there's some safety factors that we want to have applied to that product in that kind of application.